Hey garden nerds, it's Christy Wilhelmi, and today this video is part of what I'm calling the Acknowledgment Series. It's new for 2017, and whenever I hear about something really cool or outside the box, or if I meet somebody who is doing some really good work in the world and making the world a better place, I want to talk to them. So today I will be talking with David Hertz of SkySource, and he is doing something amazing. He's making water out of air. So we're going to take a moment to speak with him and acknowledge him for what he's doing in the world. Let's go. Okay. Hi, David. Thank you so much for meeting with me and with my YouTube subscribers. Let's start with who you are and what you do. Can you tell our YouTube subscribers a little bit about yourself?
Sure. Happy to. My name is David Hertz. I'm an architect in Venice Beach. I've been practicing for over three decades on sustainable design, moving towards a regenerative, restorative building. That's a building that gives back more than it takes.
So what does that look like in terms of the building structure or the materials you're using?
Well, mainly the energy that's being produced. So for instance, solar photovoltaic can be employed to give back more energy than the building consumes.
I love that. So it's zero, what's that called?
Well,
net zero?
More than zero net energy. Net zero is great because you're carbon neutral, but net positive is even better.
So the idea, electricity?
Yeah, the idea, and we have the technology to do it, but the idea is that we've done enough damage with our buildings, consuming over 40% of all U.S. annual resources, so we need to do more. So our buildings can actually be more than net zero, they could be net positive. We could actually grow more food, for instance, on the buildings, or have more oxygen-producing plants because we have more surface area than on, a vacant land because we have all the walls. So it's possible. What we haven't been able to do, especially in California, is solve our water issue.
Right.
Because we don't have water that's natural to this area, and it has to be imported at great energy costs over long distances. And we can't really, there's limits to conservation, and there's limits to how much we can collect when it occasionally rains.
So is that what brought you to SkySource?
That's exactly what brought me to SkySource. Was I heard about this technology of taking water out of the atmosphere and was shocked that the ocean evaporates into the troposphere and renews itself on a weekly basis and has more potential water than all the rivers on the planet, but it's hydrologically cleansed.
I love this stuff. This is so cool. So what did you do?
So I put this machine behind me that makes 150 gallons per day by basically condensing the ocean air. And it turns it from water vapor. When we have things like 80% relative humidity, that means 80% of the water relative to the air or to the temperature is the water vapor is actually water that can be harnessed out of the air. So I'm a couple blocks from the beach. So the idea was, let's use solar energy, which I produce on the roof, to drive this Skywater machine that will make 150 gallons of water, and let's give it away for free to the community, especially the community in need that is underserved with the ability to have water, because we're right off the Venice Boardwalk. This alley is heavily trespassed by a lot of homeless people, a lot of transients, and everybody from skaters and locals that just would like an access to clean water.
Right. Yeah.
We also provide this water not only from this bottle filling station, which is open 24 hours a day and just allows water to be pumped into a container, which we also provide, but we provide using the hose and pump. We work with a nonprofit called Safe Place for Youth. We employ two formerly homeless kids aged out of the foster care program. They come several times a week with a truck with a water tank, and they take about 100 gallons of water every trip, and they water 82 urban community farm boxes that we've worked with community healing gardens around Venice in the Oakwood section.
Right, there are these, if you drive through Venice Beach, you'll find these raised beds. They're like 3x6 raised beds. They're about 18 inches tall, and they're on the corners of the streets, and people are gardening in them, and you're saying that they're getting watered from this water here.
Right, so what would happen is oftentimes people would come by and they'd say, hey, roll down their window and say, you know, don't you realize, you know, these gardens are fantastic, but we're in a drought, and people weren't adopting the boxes because they didn't want to pay the water fines.
Right.
So now they say, hey, guess what? These boxes are watered using solar energy made from water made down the street in Venice. We're formerly homeless kids, and we're watering these with water made from air.
That's so fantastic.
Yeah. So if some people don't have solar panels on their roofs or solar electricity available to them, what can they do to hook this up in their home or garden or something like that?
Sure. The atmospheric water generators can just be plugged in for the small ones or wired in to 220 for the larger ones. So you don't need alternative energy to run them if you have power. But it's particularly nice when you could say that, you know, I've made this water without using any energy to make it. You know, the energy water nexus, I mean, we use 19% of California's energy budget for the distribution of water.
Right.
People don't make the equation that there's a lot of energy embodied in water. And the same is true, although a lot less, if you're making it with a machine. But there's nothing like using alternative energy to make your own water.
Right. And so you mentioned these garden boxes that are happening around Venice. Is there another place that you're utilizing this system?
We're currently working. We have a project on an aquaponic farm in Big Sur where we make 600 gallons a day. We have properties in Malibu, people, the Malibu people in Santa Barbara that are where the groundwater aquifers are being drawn down, and they're actually paying over $5,000 a month just in water fines, solely to keep the oak trees and trees on their property from dying. So it's also about preservation of our aquifers, because if our aquifers are drained down as they are being depleted so rapidly, then we're losing our landscape. You know, we've already lost over 1 million trees in California alone. So preservation of the aquifer is critical. And if in areas, especially along the coastal communities where there's reasonable temperature and high humidity, and when you actually look worldwide and you look at water scarcity and you look at high humidity and high temperature, they're actually closely aligned. So we are working with our nonprofit, Go Water Initiative, to bring water to Haiti and Africa. We're working with Community Healing Gardens on a project in Watts right now, where we're trying to raise money for the Skywater machine for a community garden on the school there.
And how much water does that device produce?
Well, that device produces 300 gallons per day.
That is so amazing. 300 gallons per day from the air. I think that's pretty cool. So can you show us the device?
Sure, happy
okay.
to.
Okay, tell me how this thing works.
So this is a Skywater. It's a model 150. It makes potentially 150 gallons per day.
Okay.
And it uses a patented process. It's an American patent, and it's called adiabatic distillation. Okay, it's
adiabatic distillation.
Right.
Okay.
It's a fancy word basically for mimicking the hydrological cycle inside a vessel. So what happens is warm air gets filtered through a filter, gets sucked through a filter, and gets drawn across a vessel. Inside the vessel and around the vessel are cooling tubes. And so much like when you have a simple cold glass of like ice water in a warm room, you get condensation that forms.
Mm-hmm.
That's all that we're doing on a mechanical level. So all of that chamber creates an environment, and inside that environment essentially rains, and the water is collected into this tank.
Okay. And so do you guys come out and drink from this in the office?
Oh yeah, we have a machine inside as well.
Okay.
That's a small machine that makes 14 gallons a day for our office of about 10, 12 people.
Ooh.
And then we also can drink out of this. We just simply pump it this way right out of the tank. And that's just pumping water that's made from air using solar energy to drive the machine.
Okay, I have to use my own. I brought my Gardenerd mug.
Okay, great.
So we have to try this.
Have a sip of fresh air,
fresh
as we like
air.
To say.
Yeah, this is so great.
So it's basically in this tank, there's water that we've collected, and we're just pumping it out.
Okay, that's delicious water made from the air. Isn't that the coolest thing ever? Thank you, David, so
You're
much
welcome.
For talking with me. And I really want to acknowledge you for the work that you're doing, because this is something, obviously, as a Californian aware of the drought, this is something we really need to be fixing, and you're actively doing that. So thank you so much.
You're welcome. We're happy to do it. We're really excited about the future that follows, like a distributed energy model for distributed water, where it's point of use.
Yes.
Instead of long distances.
Right. So if people want to know more about this, where should they look?
SkySource.org.
SkySource.org. Okay, anything else you want to add before we finish?
That's it. Thanks.
All right, everybody. Thanks for watching. And if you like this video, like, subscribe, and share it with your friends. And be sure to turn on notifications so you can find out when our next video comes online. Thank you, David.
Cheers.
Cheers.